It is important to do the supplication prayer to the Guru, who is the condensed nature of all the Buddhas and the three deities. So in that way, one have to feel the sense of the nature that that within the Guru itself, there is no anything object of refuge left out, not been condensed in Guru's nature. So in this way, as one do the supplication prayer and also going through the Guru Yoga practice, and as one just concentrate into such practice, then through that one can receive the blessing, you know, just gradually. So if one have doubt, then you know, just any time there cannot get success. So this our mind, not even just for one moment, could not, you know, settle down. So it is important, you know, all the time how to settle down one's mind and then do the, you know, practice. So during this retreat time also, of course, one should, you know, engage into practice, and not only that, while you just, you know, go back to home, also similar like this, if one just maintain and engage into the Dharma practice, then it is definitely good. So during the retreat time, somehow with all this practice, maybe settle down a little bit, but if one could not maintain, then once you go back to home, and then again, rest of all sorts of afflictive emotion and thought arise, then one could not have the power or the strength of the Dharma practice. So in that way, one need to have a very stable that mindfulness, and always need to have a very, you know, kind of stable mind. With that, if one just supplicate to the Guru and all the triple gem, then that will bring the benefit. So just thinking oneself as a Dharma practitioner, not necessarily have to have that pride, and having pride or ego doesn't benefit at all. So without that, if one concentrate into this Dharma practice with the belief and devotion in the objects of refuge, and then even any time when death happens to oneself, at that time also one could receive the benefit and all the blessing. So of course, this basically the five poisons of this afflictive emotion, And moreover, the self-arisen ego or the co-emergent ego, that those kind of thoughts, one have to work how to get rid of it. So of course, to get rid of these egos and so forth, not easy, you know, it is difficult, but, you know, constantly one work with it and try to just, you know, practice, then, you know, just slowly one can get there. So as you receive all this Gandho, Talung and many other teachings, including profound empowerments during this, you know, retreat time. So based on that, you try to work with your mind stream that at least get some change that towards the Dharma. So it is always important that one's body, speech, mind, the whole mind stream be mingled with the Dharma, and at the same time all those beings, whether they are high or low, and doesn't matter, to all of them, where one could to just give rise to the compassion to take care of them. Whatsoever this worldly activity we may involved in, that there is no anything that which can really just bring happiness, instead that is cause of, you know, suffering. So even that someone may have the whole wealth of the just, you know, world, even for oneself, still one will not be satisfied and still have that kind of, you know, the desire wanting more. So in that way, not having so much attachment in relation with the mundane worldly activity, because they are just, you know, empty, so not to have that grasping, and at the same time then one try to develop one's, you know, faith, devotion, belief towards the object of refuge. Yeah, so in this way, then you all engage into Dharma practice, that whatever you can just, you know, involve in.